The idea of implanting a microchip into your body is no longer science fiction. In the future, after a quick implantation procedure, you could be able to simply point at a vending machine to access your favorite drink. Doctors would be able to read your vital signs while you're at home. By waving your hand, you could unlock your front door or pay for your train tickets. And this is just the beginning. People around the world are already installing RFID chips into their bodies. Why? Microchip implants have evolved from something reserved for the most dedicated biohackers on Reddit to a useful daily tool. Like Elon Musk's Neuralink, microchipping has its roots in the philosophic idea of transhumanism. This theory states that humans will eventually evolve beyond their physical and mental limitations using science and technology. Microchipping could be a stepping stone for this cyborg evolution. Currently, RFID chips can only perform basic functions, so we still have a ways to go. Likewise, there are serious questions about the implants, ranging from long-term toxicity to hacking and privacy. For some, microchipping feels too close to an episode of Black Mirror. But this has not stopped companies from developing commercial microchips, or a growing number of people from implanting them. However, RFID technology is not as new as you might think. But what is an RFID chip? Radio Frequency Identification Technology, or RFID, has been around for decades. RFID luggage tags are used to make sure your bag gets to the right place. RFID ear tags are used to register and track livestock throughout the United States. Every day, pets safely receive RFID implants, just in case they ever get lost. You probably already have an RFID chip on your contactless credit card. RFID implants used for humans are microchips about the size of a grain of rice, encased in a biosafe glass tube. The implant is inserted into the top of your hand, right under the skin. It comfortably sits between your thumb and index finger. Passive RFID chips, like those used for implants, do not have a power source. They rely entirely on the reader as their power source. You can think of them almost like a barcode. In 1998, British scientist Kevin Warwick, also known as Captain Cyborg, became known as the first human to receive an RFID implant. University of Reading researchers monitored Warwick as he walked through the halls while operating tagged doors, heaters, and lights around the building without ever needing to touch them. Nonetheless, the development and adoption of RFID implants have been slow. In the early 2000s, American companies like Verichip tried to create their own healthcare-oriented microchip implants, only to later realize that 90% of Americans were not comfortable with the technology. The broader concern is that chip technology could be used to track people's movements. Before the company's growth was halted, Verichip proposed using the implants to track and monitor migrant workers. It is not hard to imagine that the chips could be abused. RFID chips present a potential security risk too, as it is possible to hack them. And in the long term, there are a lot of questions about toxicity. But there is some good news. A new wave of tech startups is working on safer RFID chips. The tech startup, 3Square Market, is developing the next generation of commercial microchip implants. They believe that the benefits of implanting RFID technology into the body far outweigh any potential anxieties about them. These next generation RFID chips could store important medical information, control automated home appliances, read vital signs, provide a more secure method of logging into smart devices, and even control your car. The possibilities are endless. They could also be used to track your loved ones, like your children or aging parents. The RFID chips offered by companies like Dangerous Things are programmable, giving users control over the code in the implant. And if this sounds like something you would like to try now, you can buy a chip implant kit directly off their website. In tech optimist countries like Sweden, a growing amount of residents are already getting microchips implanted under their skin. The interest of implants is moving beyond just a trend. There are growing communities across the internet that are dedicated to RFID implants, and medical companies are investing resources into perfecting them. The only thing preventing widespread adoption is the public's concerns.